Hello and welcome to PowerBI Zone. Today we see the difference between a duplicate and a reference query. The first question that might come to your mind is, where do you get these options of reference query and duplicate query? So for that, I've already loaded the financials Excel which comes with PowerBI. I'll also be giving the PBIX file in this video description. So you need to go to Home and click on Transform Data. So under the Transform Data pane, when you right click on this query, financials query, right, this particular thing, you have to right click over here and you will get these two options, right? One is duplicate, the other is reference. So in this video, the duplicate and reference queries will be our topic of discussion. So coming to the main point, what is the difference, right? So I have tried to explain the difference diagrammatically over here. So the reference query, let's come to the reference query first. So the reference query's source is the original query and it is linked, right? So reference query is sort of linked to the original query. But duplicate query is not linked to the original query at all. So in other words, if you do any changes to the original query, let's say I delete 5 columns from the original query, those 5 columns are going to be deleted from the reference query also because it is linked. But those 5 columns won't be deleted from your duplicate query. As simple as that. So let's try to understand this in Power BI desktop level. So I'm still in my transform data pane. I'll quickly do some changes. So you see on the right hand side over here, if you are able to see the applied steps. So these are the applied steps that come in with any query, right? So what I want to do is I want to do some changes and see whatever changes I do will be shown under the applied steps. So let me go ahead and delete the segment column. So as soon as I click remove, it says removed column. Go ahead and rename the product columns as product, let's say category. Okay, so it will say renamed columns. So anything you do to your query, it gets reflected under the applied steps. So I have done these changes, right? Now let me go ahead and create one duplicate query. Call this as financials dupe. And create a reference query. Call this as financials ref. Great. Now the first difference is, as you can see, the applied steps of the original financials query will be present in your duplicate query. Let me select the duplicate query. Now I have the duplicate query selected. You see on the right hand side, if I zoom in, the applied steps, all these 5 applied steps are present. Correct, but if I select the reference query and then zoom in and go to the applied steps, you see those 5 applied steps are not present. It's only the source. Correct. So whatever changes you have done to your financials, and after that you have created your duplicate and reference, right? So those changes are preserved. Look, product underscore cat is there, right? And the segment column is not there, what the column that you removed. Correct. So all the changes are preserved, and after that this reference query's source has become your financials. So this is the financials along with the applied steps. All these 5 applied steps has already become as a source for this financial ref. Okay, great. So I hope you are clear with this difference. Now what happens is we will do some other changes after we have created the duplicate and reference queries. So let me go to the original query financials. Now I will remove this product cat underscore. So I'll remove this and I'll also remove the discount band. Remove this. Correct. Okay. Now let's go to the duplicate. Are these two columns removed? No. Product cat is also there, discount band is also there. Why? That's because duplicate and financials are two separate tables altogether. Correct? And now if you go to your reference query, you will find that those two columns are not present. Why? as I told you earlier, the reference query source is going to be your financials. So anything you do to your financials will get reflected in your reference. Let's say what happens if I try to delete the original query. Okay, so duplicate, there will be no effect because it's independent of the financial query, right? So duplicate won't be affected. However, it will tell that I cannot delete my financials because there is a dependency from financials onto reference, right? So let me try to delete this particular financial. Let's see what it says. The financials query cannot be deleted because it's being referenced by another query, which is financials ref. Correct. So in order to delete this, you have to delete the financials ref table first. So I'll right click, I will simply delete the financials reference. So financial ref is now deleted. After that, you can go ahead and delete your financials. Great. So I hope this particular explanation is pretty much clear to you. Guys, if you're liking my video, please do not forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon for any updates that you want from Power BI Zone. Have a great day. Bye-bye.